Not long ago, Apple officially introduced that the iPhone 15 series now supports the Qi2 wireless charging standard. This means you can charge your iPhone at 15 watts even without the MFM certification. Except for the iPhone 15 series, the iPhone 13 and 14 series can also support Qi2 after updating to iOS 17.2. So, let's take a look at how the Qi2 wireless charger performs and compare it to the Apple MagSafe. Before the test, let's briefly introduce the Qi2. Qi2 is the new generation wireless charging standard introduced by the WPC in 2023. The standard incorporates the MPP based on Apple's MagSafe technology. It aims to provide a better user experience and pave the way for the development of new features and enhanced functionalities. It also works on Android phones, but isn't widely available yet. This time, Treasure Lab got a Qi2 MPP wireless charging module from Novolta. As you can see, the appearance is very similar to the Apple MagSafe, and it has a USB-C input. The charging power can be up to about 19 watts when using it to charge the iPhone with Apple original 30-watt charger. The voltage and current are about 9 volts and 2 amp. After switching to the Apple MagSafe charger, the power is about 18 watts and cannot reach 19 watts. Due to the loss of the wireless charging process, the test results are higher than 15 watts. Next, we'll fully charge the iPhone 15 with the Apple MagSafe. The voltage is always around 9 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 4 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 18.7 watts for the first 10 minutes, then the power fluctuates obviously, and it gradually drops to 13 watts and 7.6 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 23 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 10 minutes to be fully charged. Replace the MagSafe with the Novolta Qi2 module. The voltage is always around 9 volts. Different from the previous curve, this one has ups and downs. So the charging curve is divided into 7 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 19.5 watts for the first 9 minutes, then the power gradually drops to 14 watts and 12 watts in turn. But the power rises to 15 watts at 49 minutes. After that, the power continues to drop to 13 watts, 8 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 32 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 2 minutes to be fully charged. Its maximum power is about 1 watt higher than the MagSafe, so the full charging time is 8 minutes shorter. Since it doesn't have a back cover, the better heat dissipation probably brings a more stable charging curve. After that, we put the Qi2 module and iPhone 15 into a 25 degree Celsius thermal tank throughout the temperature test. After 1 hour of charging, the maximum temperature is 42.9 degrees Celsius. Since the module does not have a back cover, the temperature of PCB is higher than that of the MagSafe. With the Qi2 standard, the iPhone can be wirelessly charged at 15 watts even without MFM certification. We got from the test that the charging power of the Qi2 module is slightly higher than the original MagSafe charger, and it also has a more stable charging curve. However, there are not many Qi2 products available for purchase so far. The accessory manufacturers will develop more Qi2 products as Apple becomes compatible with the Qi2 standard. Of course, there also will be more Qi2 products available for Android. Let's wait and see. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!